There is a lot of things who help us to create our fantasies and build our passion for something. There is a family, friends, maybe school. Sometimes books, and in my case it was books by Jules Verne and so many others amazing writers like Carl May. And then movies. In all Czechoslovakia, we had such a great movie director, Karel Zeman, and I really love all his movies. They are full of fantasies, full of amazing, amazing designs. And then it's one movie. That movie, it's so funny. It's a kind of crazy comedy, and it's full of steampunk style, full of 19th century technologies. And I really love that movie, and I believe that movies like this, we've got quite a few of them in Czechoslovakian cinematography. So I believe that movies like this help me to build my passion for vintage and for steampunk. So let me take you to my next project I made, and I really hope you will enjoy it. Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting, back again. And today I'm coming to share with you my design theme project for Minds Beretti. It's shop, Etsy shop, amazing Etsy shop with digital kits. And this time I used, it's one of those latest released steampunk style. I didn't make something proper steampunk for a very long time, and I have to say I really enjoy it. I print out this collection a few times in different sizes, and this and a few small bits and pieces, it's what I've got left. So you can see how amazing, beautiful paper it is. Gorgeous images. And I'm going to share with you what I made, and I have to say I really enjoy it. I made file folder junk journal. It looks like this. And that basic, it's very easy. I promise it's very easy. I made it somewhere and I lost it again. Because it's the second time when I'm taking this video. I will explain you why. I will show you how I made that basic for my journal. I've got this very simple file folder. It's just two pages without those beautiful, amazing flaps. It's just very simple file folder. So I took it and I folded it half like this. Fold it half. And then I cut one side here. So I end up with this one. You will end up with this. It's open from one side. Then you will fold it again back. It was before, it was like this. Then we fold it and we put one side, and you will fold it again and you will put one cutted side on this and one on bottom, and you've got basic for your journal. I placed glue here and here. It was made pocket from the top here. And I've got three basic pages. It's back side, front side, and that middle. And I'm going to show you how I decorated what I made. And I really enjoyed this amazing collection. It's full of gorgeous images, which you can use totally different way. And I just love it. I really love that. I used loads of stuff from this collection. I used loads of stuff from Wild Orchid Crafts, those wooden dies, wooden ornaments, those gears. It's, I think it's not chipboard. It's something between chipboard and wood. Wood, I think so. And it's really gorgeous. It's from Wild Orchid Craft. And also for that rusty effect, I used those liquids I've got from my amazing friend from Spain, Elena. I didn't hear from her for a very long time. I have to write her some message. She sent me this amazing stuff of rusty patina liquids. You can make, it's not rusty patina liquids, all of them, but you can make amazing dose effects. It's from, oh my god, I have to take my Sherlock Holmes eye again. This one, you know, because those letters are too small, are too teeny tiny, and I just couldn't read it. Pardon me. This collection, it's made in My Mary Spa. My Mary Spa, made in Italy. It's who made those amazing acrylics, paints, and those rustina or green patina, blue patina effects, and it works amazingly well. I have to find it again, because that rusty patina, I've got nearly empty. Here it's basic, it's like iron. Another basic, it's like gold, and another one, it's white. And when you mix them with those liquids, with those kind of acids, this is blue patina, this is green patina, and this is that rust patina. And it makes really amazing things with your dyes, with your embellishments. So I used that, and I used I think few papers from Graphic 45, like my background, few book pages. So I'm going to show you what I made. I enjoyed that layout this time. It was so amazing, because there is so many gorgeous images. You can fussy cut out and make them like your layout in your layout. Oh my god. Sorry. I think you understand me. So this is my front cover. I used glossy accent for those glasses. Googles. Whatever, how it call it. Those. I use glossy accent here, and I used glossy accent for this number. Here I made pocket behind, and here I used a book page, and I decorated with stencil, and I went over it with ink, and I make it look like very rusty, very old, not floor, wall. Hopefully I am in view. I'm not sure if I am in view. I'm gonna just check it out. My camera, it's far, far away. You know, that last time I've been like this. So you could see only the bottom part. So hopefully now I'm gonna be in view. I have to keep myself here. Sorry. So here I use those Wild Orchid Crafts gears. Also, this is from Wild Orchid Craft. This is clocks from this collection. Also, this beautiful image is from this collection. And that this is book page, yeah. And this one, it's, I think, from Google. I'm guessing. So I made pocket behind. Here is the first pocket I made. I also made few those mixed media tags, basic, just basic. I used one paper from this collection, but only image I will show you later. Only image you can see from that from that paper. It's small man. All other stuff, it's covered with all those colors. I went crazy with that. And here I'm using those, I think you call them dividers or file folders, dividers. And I choose all which I've got with steampunk letters. So here I've got STE, and there will be that continue. So all together will give you steampunk. And here I've got just this beautiful ephemera. So this is in first pocket, also in that cover. And when you open it, we are here. Here, I have to keep myself here. Oh my god, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, hopefully I'm gonna be in view. Here I made, for that basic, I used black card with opening. And I decorated inside, I decorated with this basic ledger paper. I doodle all around a little bit. And here you can see another image from this beautiful collection. I made it like my tuck spot or like my pocket. And it's really gorgeous just on that ledger paper. It looks amazing. It looks really stunning. Here I've got just few ephemeras and another that tuck on that one sheet. I was, you know, I was so, I'm going to make some amazing mixed media tags. And when I finished, I was like, oops, I tried. And here we've got pocket. I've got pocket here and a few tags. And again, I use those Wild Orchid Craft gears. And this beautiful numbered circle, not sure how you, token, probably token. Here I made pocket, and all those beautiful, gorgeous papers are from this steampunk collection from Mind's Beretti shop. I will put a link down below for this shop. And I made this large pocket, not large with size, but I mean deep pocket. And here is this ephemera, maybe something else. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Here is that another reason why I had to, oh my god, I have to take that video again. Because I've got few those tags. And I fussy cut out loads of them out of, you know, those cereal boxes. And I cover, and I use this paper from this collection on one side. But on that other side, it was that still that cereal box. And when I took that first video, I was like, ooh, here you can see that. So I have to finish those tags. I've got few of them in the end of that journal as well. So here is small tag, here this small ephemera in this pocket. And I used few metal gears and they are still moving, so you can play with it. And it's like this gorgeous envelope. I like it, this style of envelope with this style of closure. Even now, it drives me crazy because yeah, it's not easy to put it there. So it was in this envelope. Oh my god, Evie. Come on. Yeah, oh, here are those two, another one. Here are those two, another tags. I thought that I've got them in that later pages. So here are those two. All of those images are from those beautiful papers. Here you can see it's plain. That vintage plain. So another two tags. Here I've got small. It's not booklet, it's just few tags. Those are those weekly cards, time cards. I put them together using this eyelet and I decorated here with those metal beads, bowl and this beautiful embellishment. So it's in this pocket as well. Also this ephemera, another two stamps, two dividers. There was steam, we've got all together steam. And here I've got another paper from this gorgeous collection. I made it like tag, and I used like embellishment this gorgeous metal, very old, very vintage button. So it's in this pocket here, and I'm telling you, I really enjoy to work with this collection because papers like this, they give you opportunity to make anything and everything out of them. Oops, this one is supposed to be there as well. And I've got pocket here for those large time clock cards. I'm again somewhere out of view, am I? Those time clock cards, they are coffee dyed. And also this tag. And here again, piece of paper from this collection with this Zeppelin. From other side, it's like this, it's like frame. So again, it can be open, loads of space for journaling or for photographies. And here, after a very long time, I used again toilet paper roll. I'm using it like my belly band for a few cards. Again, just few cards together. It can be slide to this side, just for a few notes. And again, I use those gorgeous papers from this steampunk collection from a Mind's Beretti shop. Really gorgeous. As you can see, I just fussy cut out pieces from that papers and glued them on those index cards. and it looks amazing. It's really gorgeous, and I decorated from the side with small filigree, and to fix it on those pages, I placed on that end this small clip. Where you are? Come here, come here, come here, come here. This small beautiful letter clip. So it's holding, including this beautiful photography of steampunk. This is steampunk photography, right? I really love all this stuff. So, to hold it all together on those pages. Yep, by the way, here I've got a few pages. Oh my god. I think it's too late. Few coffee dye pages. So, holding all together on those pages, I'm using this small letter clip. So, it's this section. And if I did intro for this video, how I am thinking I'm gonna do it. You saw a few small sharing of Czech movies, Czechoslovakian and Czech movies, which probably made me love all that steampunk stuff and all that vintage stuff from 90s. Because those movies was just amazing, really amazing, and I'm still watching them. So that's why probably I love steampunk and that vintage style, because it was just too... It was always took me to that fantasy world, to my fantasy world, when I wanted to be in that age, in that time. So if I made that intro, if not, I will tell you later. Here a few texts. I used again images from this gorgeous collection, and I'm holding it over those pages. It's like decoration, and here this gorgeous man in those top hats, and it's like probably bookmark. I'm just place it over those pages again, few coffee dye pages, so lots of space for journaling. Come here and hold that man. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Good. So it's here, and here we've got another layout. And again, I use those Wild Orchid Crafts dies, whatever it is. Here it's another beautiful image from this collection. I really love all that collection. Here. Another paper from this collection, and I doodle all around again. Here, amazing image of Eiffel Tower with that Zeppelin. And it's pocket behind, large pocket behind. It's that middle section. So here, supposed to be large, large pocket. If. Yes, it's here. And I don't have anything inside because I place it wrongly. All that stuff all around it. This supposed to be inside. Yes, aha. Oh my god, Evie, you are horrible. Like this. Here I've got three top pockets. So, right behind this image, it's one pocket. And I've got what I've got inside. No, right now I've got inside just this ephemera. Then, it's that large pocket from that basic of your journal. And I've got there this one. Here I made this tag. Using all those papers and glossy accent and few gears, like embellishment from that other side. It's space for journaling. And I decorate it with piece of leather. So this is in that a very large pocket, in basic pocket. Here is very small booklet. Again, another papers from this gorgeous collection. And as you can see, it's made like corset, so I use that image of corset. I'm gonna open it. I use that image of corset for my spine of this mini journal because it was just called for that, and I used eyelets like decoration and those small balls, ribbons, and it's very small basic journal. Out, and from that other side, we have this gorgeous man with camera on his hat and with those googles. And again, I used the glossy accent. I'm not sure if you can see that, but are those drops in those lenses, all those lenses. And I really enjoyed this time to make all those layouts. I adore art of Heather Jacob. She is amazing, amazing artist. Unfortunately, I didn't find any her YouTube channel, but I'm always visiting her her blog, because then I've got her. I'm watching her on Facebook, because this lady, it's wow, it's amazing. She's really amazing, amazing artist. I love everything what she made. So I've been inspired by her with all those layouts. I'm not good as she is at all, but I'm trying. I'm trying to learn from her how to place all those layouts, all those tabs and small things all around, including the doodling on your pages, because she made all this stuff. Also, those tags put together like decoration, and it's brilliant, like your pocket. It's everything inspired by her. So this, also this cutting edges like decoration, it's inspired by her. So all I know, it's inspired by you guys. I'm learning just from you. It's amazing what you know. And here I've got a few ephemeras, just like this. Small ephemeras. Here is that taxi. It's that small man. He survived. Yay. This is only image you can see from all that sheet of this beautiful paper from this collection. It's only image which survived from my layering of mixed media. So this is tag I made as well. And here small teeny mini tags. And I think I was telling you something about something. And I don't remember that now. Here I've got just small envelope, which is holding those papers, coffee dyed papers here. Again, space for journaling. And I've got like my decoration or holder of those pages, this small envelope. It's just hanging over those pages. And I made pocket from this side, and I use this gorgeous image I found on Google. Here is just small tag. And here I've got paper clip, which is holding that envelope. It's nothing inside yet, but this envelope I made from those gorgeous papers as well. And as you can see, here is like envelope. I noticed that when I put this together, I noticed like, oh my God, this is envelope. See? Just gorgeous. So it's here. Come on, go there. And it's hanging over those pages. And it's making beautiful effect of chain. And here I've got few images. This top hat man. Again, small ephemera. And here, gorgeous image of steampunk train. Hopefully you will see all those images without too much shine from my lamp. Hopefully. And hopefully you will see that. That I will be not out of view again. Here again, few pages, coffee dyed pages. It's here. Oops. Go there. And you here, come here. It's holding with this paper clip. And here I've got last page. Here I've got that end of all of steam punk. Here is that punk. Steampunk dividers. Here I've got small tag using all those images. Gorgeous images. And here I made small layout. This is, I think, from Sacrafter Shop, The Story of Today. It's wooden piece, gorgeous wooden piece. So I believe I purchased that in Sacrafter Shop. hopefully, I'm not sure. And all those, it's from this gorgeous steampunk collection. Here is like tuck spot, so something can be slide behind. Here I made pocket, and here I've got again some, this is vintage photography, and here I made very small booklet, very small, simple booklet. Here I use this piece of acetate, and I was thinking how much I learned from you, how many styles of decorating and everything. And when we learn something new, we sometimes forget what we already know, knew, what we already learned. So I tried to remember myself what I already know about embellishments, about interesting things you can add. So I tried here. I saw it somewhere a while ago, and I used it a few times ago. And I'm using it again, just embossed piece of acetate, and I used permanent ink, and then I wipe it on that flat side. And those embossed pieces just make gorgeous embellishment. Here is a piece of those gorgeous papers as well. Here you can see tickets. You can fussy cut out them and use them like embellishments. And here just a few pages. Again, coffee dyed pages. And I mix them all together with all those gorgeous images, all those gorgeous papers from this steampunk collection. It's just very simple, small booklet with few stamps. Oops. So all those images you can find in this gorgeous collection. This one, I just love this one. I'm not sure why, because it's, I don't know, it's just gorgeous image. Oops. Here it's like tuck spot. Here is like tuck spot. So it's a very simple booklet. It's here in this pocket. Here or steampunk. Steampunk. Here is this tag, it can be slide just behind, and here we are on the end. Here, this man, it's from this collection as well. I'm not sure if you got, sorry for glare, if is it too much shiny from my lamp. Again, few those gorgeous gears from Wild Orchid Craft. Here I made like connection between that man and between those gears, and I'm using it like my tuck spot or like my pocket. Here you can see that gorgeous image. So I've got tuck spot here, and here is tuck. I used all those gorgeous images from this collection. Same on this other side. Here is small hot air balloon. Really gorgeous collection. Here just very old vintage photography. Sure, if you don't have that strong shining. And here another paper from the, yeah, those clocks I used in that first layout. Here you can see that here I used those clocks from this collection. Here you can see them, those gorgeous clocks. And here this funny top hat man's, this ephemera. And here is just small, teeny, teeny, tiny image from these papers as well. So this is my sharing for today. This is my design theme project for Mainz Beretti and her gorgeous papers. I really enjoy to work with it because you've got so many options how you can fussy cut out those papers. As you can see, you can make tags, basic pages, even tag spots using just few images or envelopes. Where is our envelope? Here we've got our envelope. Over here. Yeah, even envelope if you will fussy cut out from those papers. All this stuff, it's very simple and gorgeous, and it's making a great effect in your project. So this is my sharing for today. I will place the link for Sophie's shop down below for mind Barati. Also, I will try to find celery of those amazingly useful. Is it useful? I hope it's the right word. Amazingly great products. Idea Patina, it's called from that. How I said so? My Mary. M-A-I-M-E-R-I. Spa. I will try to find some celery from with those, because ladies, I'm telling you, this stuff is totally awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So this is my sharing for today. I really hope you will like it. I really hope you will try to do some your steampunk. If you will do so, if you will be inspired with this project, please share it with me. I will love to see your project. Sometimes it was now when I received that amazing journal from Svetlana. She made there that Haydn pocket and also that magnetic clip from Canpul rings. And I was like, oh my god, that's so amazing. And I know she made it because I've got it in my tutorials. It doesn't mean that I invited all those things, but she made it because I've got tutorial for it, and she saw it on my channel, and it was, oh my god, I felt so happy that, wow, I inspired someone. Oh, I'm so happy. You know, it made me so happy. Really. So if you will make something inspired by this journal, please share it with me. I've got Facebook page. I will put link for that Facebook page down below as well. Place your photographs on there, and I will love to have a look on your projects. I will love to see what you make. And if you like this video, please share it with your friends. Hope maybe someone else will like to see my creations. Thank you so much for all your amazing comments and support, and also for all your amazing ideas, because without you, I can't lean what I know now. I couldn't lean what I know now, and I can't lean more. Without you, it will be impossible. So thank you so much. Hopefully you will visit Sophie's shop, because it's worth it. She's got amazing stuff there. She's got romantics, those travelers, those steampunk. She's got all kind of amazing digital kits. So please pop up there, go to find Wild Orchid Crafts if they've got still those dies. What is it? Wooden dies, probably. And I will try to find some seller with this amazing stuff. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for your support. Hopefully you've got great time. Take care and see you next time. Bye.